This is part 3 of lecture 7 on narrowband modems. In part 1, I talked about binary modulation techniques, and I reviewed like relationship between error rate and signal-to-noise ratio, and coherent versus non-coherent binary modulation techniques, and FSK versus PSK modulation. In the second part of the lecture 7, I talked about multi-level modulation techniques. First, I started about talking about pulse amplitude modulations and multi-level pulse amplitude modulation. Then I talked about QAM modulations, and at the end I talked about multiple phase modulation techniques, and I gave you some equations about also multi-frequency modulation techniques. In this third part of the lecture, I will talk about basically two popular modulation techniques which are used in cellular networks. One of them is offshoot of frequency shift keying, which is called GMSK or Gaussian minimum shift keying, and the other one is power for QPSK, which is offshoot of phase shift keying techniques. Basically, performance of these two are very, very close, and though they look to be FSK and PSK, the implementation are also very similar. And I show you that how MSK can be implemented as a QPSK actually. But the importance of these two is because GMSK is used in GSM, and power for QPSK because it is used in IS-136 and Japanese digital cellular, and also in Tetra. But to start this discussion, basically I'm talking about modulation techniques which have limited number of points in the constellation, which are used for long distance radio links. Usually for long distance radio links, you cannot have many levels because that adjustments of the levels would create difficulties. So originally people were using binary PSK, binary FSK, and then you go to multi-frequency FSK or you go to QPSK. And that's more or less the popular ones in radio communication. So then they go to another level of detail to just modify QPSK to have better efficiency, to be better. Number one, what is the meaning of that betterness? So I have a very simple QPSK and I make some variation of that and methods to change it to make it better. Okay, what better? Number one is that if I have like a QPSK modulation, for example, I send these four, and if channel is perfect, I receive a signal constellation at the receiver that is the same four. Okay? But life is not perfect. I have at least additive noise. If I have additive noise, when I send these points in the transmitted constellation, at the receiver I get things like that. So I get clouds rather than single things. And then some of these points, suddenly they cross the decision line and I make error. But that occurs like 1 out of 10,000 times or something like that. Okay, but still I'm keen on that. For data, I want to have data is, I mean, I don't want to have any error, I mean, in the networks. So as a result, I add coding and I try to be cautious. But anyway, so this is additive noise. But additive noise is not the only problem. I may have also phase shift or phase jitter. If I assume phase jitter is like fixed, phase jitter causes this type of thing. So rather than receiving the point in here, it moves back and forth like that or like this. This is the effect of phase jitter. And then I have harmonic distortion and effect of nonlinearities, which they spread the point like this, the received points. So what will happen is that These are mostly the things which are on the telephone line. These are impairments on the telephone line. To just fight with these things, I have to do certain things. But on top of that, when I go to the radio modems and I want to design for cellular networks, I have a lot of other constraints. Among these constraints, one is bandwidth efficiency. Bandwidth efficiency means that I want to increase my data rate within the same bandwidth. Okay. The second one is power efficiency. Well, for bandwidth efficiency, for example, QPSK, the bandwidth efficiency is twice as much as binary PSK. Okay. So data rate over the bandwidth. That's the bandwidth efficiency. Now, power efficiency. Power efficiency means that within the same bandwidth, I want to consume less power. I compared, for example, binary PSK and FSK for that purpose, and I said that, like, for that particular comparison, we had like 3 dB better performance with PSK. The third item that is very important for design of modulation technique is for the cellular network is your modulation technique should be resistant to multipath. And multipath exists, but it affects more certain modulation techniques. So you want to be, but that relationship is very complex. So as a result, to check that, they do like channel simulations, like the one that you do in your project, and based on that channel, they compare the performances of modulation techniques. Very complete multipath channel. Another issue which is simple and important is out-of-band radiation. Out-of-band radiation means that, like, I have, like, in cellular networks, I have these bands next to one another. Then when I design a modem, really it is not as clean as it is in here. It is like this. Always I have these side things. This is out-of-band radiation, which goes as interference to the neighbors. And I told you, cellular networks are what? Are interference limited, like networks. So I have to like be careful about that. Now, so this issue of dropping these side lobes low is more important in cellular network than in, let's say, wireless LANs or than in voice band modems. Now, to bring the side lobes lower, people try to have two things. I mean one thing. That's they try to provide continuity to the phase. You remember that I was sending these cosines, and then I was changing the phase, for example, like that, for binary PSK. Okay. Sometimes at the end, when I finish in here, and I start in here, I have a jump. Or in here, I have like a fast reverse. When you have these abrupt changes, what will happen to the Fourier transform? Anytime that you have a step, you spread the band. Okay? So they cause more changes in here, in these side lobes. So one thing that people, one type of modulation technique that people were keen on for the radio system was the so-called, they call it continuous phase modulation. Means that when this cosine is changing like that, when I want to change the frequency, for example, I change it without changing phase. This feature is called continuous phase. So people were thinking of continuous phase modulation technique. Why? Because the side lobes. I mean, I don't have this high side lobes in there. So this is one issue which is specific to radio channels, while bandwidth efficiency, power efficiency are specific for any medium. And then if you want to talk about resistance to multipath, I'm talking about cellular systems. They are narrowband systems. Okay. Resistance, more or less, are the same. Okay? But this out-of-band radiation and continuous phase being continuous phase to control the out-of-band radiation was very, very important. And people had a lot of patents in 70s, early 80s, around like continuous phase modulation, and they examined a bunch of modulation technique, and finally they settled on GMSK and Pahlavan for QPSK. Now, another issue which is also important for radio modems is the issue of constant envelope. Constant envelope means that when I'm sending these cosines, if the amplitude changes like that, I mean goes up and down, it's not good for the amplifiers, because you are using mostly class C amplifiers, and for class C amplifiers, for the power, you have non-linearities if amplitudes are changing. Okay, so efficiency comes lower. So basically, people who wanted to design like radio modulation techniques for long distances, they were focusing on something simple like QPSK, and a variation of the QPSK, which is constant envelope and continuous phase, to the extent that they can. But the relationship between that constant phase and whatever else and the side lobes is so complex that they come up with different patents, and they just compare them and see that what is in there. Okay, in the side lobes. Now, under that light, people have gone to these variations of QPSK. The first variation of QPSK that people started to think about for radio modems was you go from QPSK to the so-called offset QPSK. What is the meaning of offset QPSK? In regular PSK, if I have, let's say, like a square pulses, I mean, I'm sending a carrier, really. I'm sending this one at this time and for the in phase, and this is my quadrature phase. Okay, so I send a pulse in here, I send another pulse in here. I have two BPSK modulation. One is in here, one is here. I start both of them at the same time in QPSK. Okay, now what will happen is that in reality I'm not sending this really, I'm sending a pulse like this, and I'm sending a pulse like this, which also has some cosine on it. It's modulated pulse like this. Okay, so at these places, both of them are low. In these places, both of them are high. So if I look at the envelope, envelope is not very constant. So one way to make the envelope more constant for QPSK is to send this one at the beginning zero, and if this is T, start this guy in the middle of this one, or at T over 2. So if you want to think about the square boxes, I send one in here, I send the other one from the middle of this. But when I add them together, now the envelope becomes more constant. Make sense? This modulation is called offset QPSK. Okay? Offset QPSK, one of the early modulation techniques for radio channel. You don't do offset QPSK for example, voice band modems. All the voice band modems are QPSK. Okay, because constant envelope is not that important there. Okay, but when you come to radio, for example, offset QPSK was very good. IS-95 in the reverse channel, they use offset QPSK because they want to have a more power efficient modulation. If you have constant envelope, you can boost up your power. I mean, reduce your power, actually, in a sense. It boosts your effective transmitted power. Okay, so in IS-95, in forward channel, where power is not that important, they use QPSK. In the reverse channel, they use offset QPSK. Okay? And that's the story of offset QPSK. Now, what happens really? What are other things which happens in here? Not only it makes the envelope a little bit more flat, it also helps in phase continuity. If I have QPSK, I may have phase shifts which may be up to 180 degrees. Because I change the phase of the in-phase and quadrature phase at the same time. If both of them are changing like at the same time, they go like that. If I do them offset and I add them together, the phase shift would be like this. It never will be pi. Okay, it's always less than a pi. So it provides also phase continuity. It improves the continuity of the phase. So if I go offset QPSK, in terms of pulse shaping, I will have more a smooth constant envelope, and in terms of phase shift, I will avoid 180 degrees phase shift. So as a result, offset QPSK is a more constant envelope and more continuous phase modulation. But how about error rates like ERF comp? That's the same as QPSK. Okay? But interference that it causes to the others, and also power efficiency in terms of implementation of the last stage power amplifier is better than QPSK. So that was the first variation. First variation over the QPSK. Now, the second issue is the issue of MSK, minimum shift keying. Minimum shift keying, first of all, I will show you a little bit later, is a sort of offset QPSK. It can be shown that it's a sort of offset QPSK. But what was minimum shift keying? I talked about it earlier with you. Minimum shift keying was an FSK signal in which the distance between the two frequencies is equivalent to half of the transmission, symbol transmission rate. Okay, FSK, the distance between two frequencies, was the same as data rate. Now, basically, if you have the good part of MSK or phase shift, any sort of frequency shift keying, is that I can use FM modulators, demodulators, which a lot of them are available for the very inexpensive ones, are available for what? FM radios. So I can very easily implement them, very inexpensively implement them. Okay? So basically what I do is that I have an FM modulator, I put like a square wave at the input, I put like this square wave, and this one is plus one, and this one is minus one, and FM modulator translate this to frequency F1, this one to frequency F2. Because it's a FM modulator. FM modulator translates the amplitude to what? To the frequency. So I send two frequencies. And at the receiver, I have an FM demodulator. And in here, I have a decision line. Demodulator turns it back to these squares. And then I have a decision line to say that what it was. So implementation of MSK is very easy. Okay, in a sense. Now, this MSK signal, we can... To implement it, we can say that we can implement it with this equation, which is FC plus DK over 40 times T. 40 is 1/4 of the one symbol. Okay? In which X of K is given by this recursion. To understand that, maybe it's good to go to the one that I had before. The data comes in, they come like, these are the information bits which are coming in, D0, D1, etc. The even odds I put in here, evens I put it in here. Okay? But in normal PSK, odds and evens, they are transmitted at the same time. In offset, they are sent at what? With like half a, it depends on how you define the T. In here, he has defined the T for one symbol. But anyways, half of that in the middle of the other one, I send this one. Okay? So what will happen is that, like, while I'm sending this cosine, I change the frequency of the other cosine in the middle of that. And then, rather than changing from here to here, I'm changing every t rather than changing every 2t. Since I'm changing every t rather than every 2t, if I have to change like pi, I do it in 2 pi halves. Okay, 1 pi half in here, 1 pi half in here. Okay, rather than having at once pi. That was why I reduced the, I improved the continuity of the phase. Okay, now, if you take in that format and put the MSK, it can be shown that MSK signal can be written in this format. This is like the frequency which is changing so much according to this of k. This of k's are like d0, d1, odds and even ones, given by this, by these two equations, in which this x of k is following this recursion. If you get these numbers, you return them back in here, you're going to have like a format in there. Now, what will happen in there is that if I take now this cosine, now I expand it. This is cosine of this times cosine of this, then sine of this times sine of this. And that's what you're doing in here after expansion. Okay, so after expansion, it can be shown. These are all algebraic manipulations. I don't go over the details of that. And then these a of k, b of k's are given with these things, where this x of k is something that I had given in here. With all of those algebraic manipulations, it can be shown that MSK can be implemented like this. This signal, in which AK and BK are related to XK by this format. In practice, I mean, what it is, with these equations, it can be shown that MSK can be implemented as an offset QPSK system. Because this one is multiplied with cosine, this one is multiplied with sine. This is for QPSK, this is the pulse shape. Pulse shape of the cosine and pulse shape of sine are like this is cosine and this is sine. The sine. They are like half a T apart from one another. This is this sine, this is this cosine. So what will happen is like this. D0, D2, D4, D6, these are the even ones. It's plus 1, I have a pulse like this, this, and then I have a change. These are differential, basically, plus, and I have a change, I keep it at 1. In here I have no change, I change it. In here I have a change, I keep it the same. Okay. Now, when you modulate that, it comes like this. This cosines are added to that. Now, the other part, which is this part, this one was this part, the other part is implemented with these two. Okay. Now, if you implement them like two, like those two, now you add this one plus this one, you end up with this, which is a minimum shifting. It's a continuous phase. Okay. Minimum two different frequencies and continuous phase and constant envelope. So basically, these equations, this derivation of these equations that I have in here, basically are showing the fact that you can implement an MSK like an offset QPSK. Detail of these derivations, I didn't go over that. They are available in the literature. They are in the book. But it's algebraic manipulations. But the basic idea out of this algebraic manipulation is that to show the fact that MSK and however for MSK and offset QPSK, I mean MSK can be implemented with offset QPSK's structure. Okay? You use these equations that I gave you in here and in the next one in here, you can basically end up to this thing. And the meaning of this thing is that if you implement this cosine like this and you implement this one like this, when you add them up, you end up with this signal, which is constant envelope, continuous phase, minimum shift gain. But implementation was what? Just like it. This implementation that I have in here is what? This is offset QPSK because I have a cosine shape over cosine, a sine shape over the sine. Means that one of my pulses is like this, the other pulse is like this. That's what I have in here and in here. This is what? This is this FC. This one is this FC. This shapes are this guy. This shape is this guy. Did you follow that? So basically one algebraic manipulation is coming from here I forgot the name of the person who did this, but it is cited in the book. Now, but basically, people have shown that rather than implementing with, like, implementing the MSK like this, you can also implement the MSK with offset QPSK. These equations and derivations that we have in here reduces to these equations. That we have in here, this equation in particular. And this equation basically is that I have a cosine with cosine pulse, and I have a sine modulated with a sine which is offset cosine. And when you add now this one and this one together, you get this. So, conclusion number one. Number one is that it can be shown. I didn't show you the detail. I just showed you the equation. I didn't go over the derivation. But I showed you that it can be shown that MSK can be implemented using offset QPSK. It is very important because it also shows that offset QPSK can produce continuous phase, continuous amplitude, if it is formed in a particular algebraic manner, can be manipulated in that way. Okay? Now, based on that, so this is the story of MSK. Now, if you want to look at the MSK now and compare it with our BPSK and QPSK. So, I'm talking about MSK, I'm talking about BPSK, I'm talking QPSK, I want to compare them. If I want to compare them, let's say that first I have like square pulses with the side lobes which are like 13 dB down. These are for square. If I have binary PSK for the same data rate, this is my bandwidth from here to here. This is the bandwidth. This is binary PSK. If I go to QPSK, what will happen? For the same data rate, my bandwidth is half of the before. Because, I mean, for the same data rate, I need half symbol rate. Okay? So, QPSK is half of, QPSK is half of BPSK in terms of bandwidth. How about MSK? MSK is something between the two. Okay? So that's the first message. that MSK is a compromise between what? Between BPSK and QPSK. What is the advantage of MSK? I can implement it with cheap FM transmitter receivers. While for QPSK, I need like two rails and some more, in fact, stuff. Now, what is GMSK? GMSK actually is an MSK with a Gaussian filter. So I have this FM modulator. If I take the data like this, I go to the FM modulator, I have MSK. If I first pass it through Gaussian filter, and now my data goes like this, and then pass this data, this is GMSK. That's it. So simple implementation, but still, constant envelope, continuous phase. What was the advantage of putting this Gaussian filter? Look, if I don't put the Gaussian filter, MSK has these side lobes which are very high. These high side lobes are not good. Why? Because they interfere to the neighbors. Okay? Now, to do that, they put this Gaussian filter, and this is the bandwidth, normalized bandwidth of that. If this is MSK, normalized bandwidth, which is the data rate times bandwidth of this Gaussian filter, okay, or bandwidth of Gaussian filter normalized with the data rate, if you want to call it, then you can get these side lobes to come down and down and down. For example, for M equals to around 0.25, I see the side lobes, which are now very, very low. And these are the numbers which are, I think, for GSM, this is like 0.25 or 0.3, something like that. So for implementations, they use this normalized bandwidth of like 0.25 or something like that for the Gaussian filter. Okay, so the bandwidth of the Gaussian filter is much lower than, not much, 1/4 of the bandwidth or 1/3 of the bandwidth of the whole system. Okay, what it does is that it pushes the side lobes down. And when the side lobes are done, we don't interfere with the neighbors. So this is the story of GMSK. People have done in the literature calculations for error rate. This is how you calculate. Again, you have the ERF complement function. This ALF that you have in here is given in here. It's a little bit for different value of the BT. This is the one that most people use. This is 0.65. Remember, I mean, now you can compare it with the others. For binary PSK, for example, you can go and compare it at how much more power it needs. The other modulation technique that people are using is, so that's about GMSK. So basically what I told you about GMSK, I gave you this important curve, which just relates that the bandwidth of that Gaussian filter, how it brings the side lobes low. Then I gave you how to calculate the probability of error of that. And in here I told you that how to implement it. I mean, how to implement it very easily. Okay. Now, and then I told you typical of 0.25 is the one that they use in most of the standard. Now, for 0.25, it's like side lobes, they go like 60 dB below. But for MSK, the side lobes are like 20 dB below. Okay. The other modulation technique which is popular is Pi/4 QPSK. Pi/4 QPSK is actually a QPSK which has two constellations. This is constellation number one, and this is, let's say, constellation number two. And what it does is that when it sends the first symbol, it picks up from this constellation. Second symbol, it picks up from this constellation. And this way it avoids that 180 degree phase shifts without going to offset QPSK stuff. Okay, so when I look at the constellation, actually I see 8 points in the constellation, but in reality it's 4 at a time. Okay, so I have four points in here. I mean, each of these points are identified with what? Two bits. But in one symbol, I send one of the two bits from this four, from this four. In the other one, I send from this four. Okay, that's basically what it is. If you look at the error rate of that, error rate is something like that. It's slightly better than error rate of GMSK. It's slightly better than that. So as a result, both of them. An implementation of this also is something like this, which is basically a modified QPSK receiver. Now, basically, they have two methods for here. I think for the QPSK, also you can do the power for differential encoded. If you do differential encoded, when your bits are coming, you have a delta phi of this one, this one, this one, this one, based on these guys. Okay, based on the two bits that you are picking up. See, you never have pi or minus phi. You have either pi over 4 or you have 3 pi over 4. So you are avoiding that 180 degrees. Okay? So this is also very simple. And these are the, how if you have the in-phase quadrature phase, as WZ, how you form these things to, in your, like, transmitter. This is just identified in here. So, in summary, what I told you was that I talked about two practical, in this last part, third part of lecture 7, I talked about requirement for the radio modems, and I told you that for radio modems, people are keen on continuous phase and constant envelope type of modulations, and people have selected GMSK and pi over 4 QPSK as two techniques that are commonly used in many of the standards. Basically, I showed you performance curves for GMSK and also gave you the equations for calculation of probability of error. Probability of error or both of them are very close, but this side lobes of GMSK are more structured in terms of control. If you want to control them, you can control them more structurally, with a better structure. Since the performance of the two are very close, both of them are used in the standards for the TDMA systems. And with that, I can close this last part of lecture 7. When we come back for lecture 8, we start to talk about effect of fading and then diversity and coding to improve the performance of the modems.